Hey guys, welcome to the Tiki Hut. My plumeria's blooming, yay! Which always reminds me of my mom, because all of my plumeria plants came from my mom's house, from one stalk of plumeria, which in my head, I think I brought her a stalk from Hawaii, and then that turned into 2, 3, 5, 10, a giant tree, and we just keep cutting the stems off and then planting them, and another plumeria plant will grow, which is why I was able to grow it. So I was sitting out, chilling out in the Tiki Hut last night, and I noticed it. It was a beautiful evening, and it just makes me happy. So my mom had her flowers and her plants and her hummingbirds. And my dad, growing up, had a lot of tortoises. He was an animal lover. So when I was very young, it started out with someone, we're not really sure, we can't remember, brought us a desert tortoise that they found going on to the on-ramp of the freeway. So my dad took it in, and then he kind of was known as the tortoise man. So then someone else found a tortoise and brought it. So now we had two tortoises. And then finally we had a third one, which he named number one, number two, and number three. Eventually, we figured out through Mother Nature that we had one male and two females. And the females would lay eggs. But the soil was so rich and deep in their backyard that it wasn't the right atmosphere for the eggs to hatch. And then my dad took this one little piece of ground and put sand in it instead. And my sister recalls, so the tortoises laid their eggs, and my sister recalls coming over one time and just going to check, and she kind of just went like that in the dirt, and it was like it started erupting, and the eggs looked like ping pong balls. That's about the size of them. And so she sees this erupting, and all of a sudden these little tiny, this big around tortoises started coming up from the sand and coming out. She'll never forget it. Well, success, finally. Now we have, I don't know, 5 or 6 more little babies. And then the tortoises kept having eggs and they kept hatching. And my mom finally said, she goes, I'm gonna put the kibosh. You have 28 tortoises. It's true. My dad had 28 desert tortoises. Now, you can't take them back to the desert. It's illegal, because once they're once they're here out of the desert, they get like this cold, and you don't want them to take it back to the other desert tortoises. So now we have 28 desert tortoises, and he would take care of them every day. He had them by age group, and he had these like laundry baskets, and they slept at night, and then in the morning he would just take laundry basket after laundry basket, and he would take the turtles out and he would put them on the grass, and he had made wooden dividers to divide the tortoises by their age category so the little ones didn't get picked on. And they would feed on the grass, and he also fed them romaine and apple slices. And my mom would give them rose petals from her roses, but she said they had to eat their vegetables first. So I grew up with 28 desert tortoises. They live for a really long time. They can live up to 100 years old. So when my father passed away, my mom couldn't take care of them. That was out of her area of expertise. So we had to find homes. One of them, we found homes for 28 desert tortoises. Check that off the list. And one of them, my friend Jennifer took, and his name's Roy. And then she sends me updates, because they go to sleep in October and they hibernate from October until March, 5 months. And then she would keep them in a laundry basket or a box in her shower, and then he would wake up and she would put him back outside. And she has a dog, and they had a love-hate relationship, kind of. He would chase her around and she would kind of put up with it. Here's a video she sent of how to get the bed all to yourself.
Every time our eyes meet, this feeling inside me is almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear your thoughts, I can see your dreams. I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting better. I want to spend the rest of my life with you by my side, forever and ever.
Jennifer, I love you for adopting Roy. It's so, when I go over there, I can see. It's like a part of my dad. It's nice. And as I say goodnight from the Tiki Hut, I wish you well. Here's some cats, my cousin's cats, looking out the window. And a giant sunflower that I found on my bike ride today. See you tomorrow.